Okay, so now let's start figuring out trigonometric function values of special angles. And the easy ones to get are what we call the quadrantal angles. I defined quadrantal angles for you previously. So they are angles that are, well, of course, the vertex should be at the origin, right? And the terminal side is one of the x-axis, you know, the positive x-axis, positive y, negative x, negative y, okay? And so these are the quadrantal angles that I have. And remember, I explained that I tend to put the angles there, right, where the terminal side is, okay? So from our previous discussion, well, all we have right now is we know how to find the trigonometric function values of an angle if we know a point on its terminal side, right? So all we really need is to find a point on the terminal side. Let's say if we have the 0 degree angle, okay, we want a point on this terminal side, which is really the positive x-axis also, okay? So you know that you can get a bunch of points here, right? So to make our lives simple, instead of getting, let's say, 100, 0, why don't we get 1, 0, okay? So that's what we're going to do for these, okay? So for here, I'm going to pick the point 1, 0. For the quadrantal angle 90 degrees, I'm going to pick the point 0, 1. You see that? Okay. For 180 degrees, let us pick the point negative 1, 0. Okay. And then for the 270 degree angle, let's pick 0, negative 1. Okay. Now, the nice thing about this choice of points is what? Well, remember that aside from the x and the y coordinates of the point, we also need the r, right? The distance of the point from the origin. And what's so nice about the distance of the point, these points from the origin, all these points are 1 unit away from the origin. So for all of these guys, r is equal to 1. All right? So I guess so. Let's see, what's the best way to do this? Yeah, actually, maybe I can do a chart for you here. Okay, hope you can see this. All right, so let's put our answers in a chart like this. So I put all my angles here, the quadrantal angles, 0 degrees, 90 degrees, 180, 270. Well, I forgot the last one, 360, which of course will have the same values as 0 degrees, right? And then I have the 6 trigonometric functions, sine, cosine, tangent, cotangent, secant, and cosecant, all right? And we know that we really just have to worry about the first three columns, right? Because the last three will just be reciprocals of these going that way. All right, anyway, so let's see. If we want the sine of 0 degrees, so I'm going to look at this point, 1, 0, right? The x coordinate is 1, the y coordinate is 0. Since sine is y over r, so sine of 0 degrees is going to be 0 over 1, right? Okay? And we know that 0 over 1 is really nothing but 0. All right? So you know how to do this. Cosine of 0 will be the x coordinate over r. So x is 1, r is 1, so 1 over 1 is just 1. So the sine of 0 degrees is 0, the cosine of 0 degrees is 1. And the tangent is just the y coordinate over the x coordinate. The y coordinate is 0. X coordinate is 1. 0 over 1 is going to be 0. Okay? So then, as I said, these three you can just do by taking the reciprocal, all right, of these. Cotangent theta is the reciprocal of tangent of theta, right? So cotangent of 0. It's going to be the reciprocal of 0, but you'll have 1 over 0, and you heard me say but, right? Okay, we never want to hear ourselves say over 0, right? In math, when you have indicates division, right? Okay, a constant different from 0 over 0 is going to be undefined, right? So let's just use for this purpose the infinity, just because I don't have a lot of room here. Later on, you'll see that it makes sense to use the symbol infinity anyways, okay? So 1 over 0 is undefined, and I will use the notation infinity to denote that it's undefined, all right? Let's see what happens to secant of theta. secant of theta is the reciprocal of cosine of theta. The reciprocal of 1 is 1, right? So if you want to write it here, 1 over 1, which is 1, okay? Cosecant of theta is the reciprocal of sine theta. Again, you see sine theta is 0, so 1 over 0 is again going to be undefined, all right? Then if you want 90 degrees, 90 degrees corresponds to the point 0, 1. So the x coordinate is 0, the y is 1. Sine is the y coordinate over r. So you'll have 1 over 1, which is 1, okay? And then you have, for the cosine, it's the x coordinate, which is 0 over r, which is 1. So you have 0, all right? Tangent is y over x, so 1 over 0, which is undefined, okay? And then you take the reciprocal of this. Reciprocal of 1 over 0 to get cotangent is 0 over 1, which is 0, okay? The reciprocal of secant is the reciprocal of cosine, rather, but cosine is 0, so the reciprocal is 1 over 0, which is undefined, okay? And cosecant is the reciprocal of sine, but sine is 1, so 1 over 1 is 1, okay? I think you know what I'm doing, so why don't I just fill in the chart by myself, okay? You don't have to watch this entire video, and I'll just zoom it into this once I'm ready, okay, when it's done. Okay, there you go. I filled in the chart, and hopefully if you did your part, you can compare your answers with mine, and I hope I'm correct, okay? Anyway, so yeah, that's how you get the trigonometric function values of quadrantal angles. Let me just make a comment here that, again, quadrantal angles, these angles don't have to be all positive, right? So we can actually call this, if we start from 360 and go go clockwise, right, from 360, from here, from 0, go like this. So really, 270 degrees can be thought of as negative 90 degrees. I don't know if you see that. Okay, so let's see. This is also the same as negative 90 degrees. This can be thought of as negative 180 degrees. 90 degrees is the same as negative 270 degrees. 0 degrees can be thought of as negative 360 degrees. And again, let me remind you that, you know, we could go crazy and go around and around, okay, generating bigger and bigger angles. So as long as they fall on one of the axes, right, either side, positive or negative, then you have a quadrantal angle, and that's how you go about finding the trigonometric function values.